to the gym. As promised, I promised you guys some more stuff on some technique drills that we can use for this episode. So that's what we're gonna do today. We're gonna focus on hands today. Sound good?
Hands. Well, got it.
All right. The reason we're gonna focus on hands, I kind of wanted to focus on feet first, but we're gonna go with hands because at the end of last session, we came to a shocking revelation.
My hands blew up.
His hands blew up.
Yeah.
He said his fingers were hurting, which is, if you're a brand new beginner on your first session and your fingers are hurting, like, we're talking not the skin, we're talking like your joints hurt, your tendons hurt, not a good sign.
Not good. I was just like death gripping everything because I don't want to die. That's
right. Yeah, you know, he was death gripping everything, over gripping, and you were basically full, something called a full crimp. You're full crimping, like every hole. Not good. So we're going to go over today the different holds, how to hold them, and then we're gonna do a drill on that. So cool, let's get started.
Easy.
So we have a bunch of holds behind us that we're gonna go over and review with Can and show you guys how to hold them. The reason why we're gonna do this is because we wanna build a really good foundation, a good understanding of the basics of climbing. That is what's gonna get you to be a good climber. Nobody can skip that, really. Technique is king. Don't let anybody tell you that physical raw power is what's gonna make you an amazing climber. It's so we're gonna go through that first because that is gonna make you the most efficient and effective climber that you can be, is having precision hands and precision feet. So today, precision hands is first up. Cool.
All right.
So let's get over to the wall and let's grab some of the holds, and I'm gonna go through which ones are which. So we're gonna start with crimps. Let's go on to a crimp. A crimp is a hold that is gonna be like in cut towards the wall. So there's a couple of ways to hold a crimp. And how you were doing it and why it was hurting your fingers so much is because you were doing something called a full crimp, which, if Fowler, if you want to get on this side, it's a little bit easier to see. He was doing something like this. This is called a full crimp, where you have your knuckle, your second knuckle of your index finger, kind of all the way up and above your fingertips. And then this thumb is coming around and gripping it like this. So this is really good for power pulling and getting like really pulling on something. However, this is the most harsh form that your hand can be in when gripping to your tendons. So it's not necessarily a great thing to have all the time.
Yeah.
So what we can do instead is we can do an open crimp or a half crimp, is we can have our fingers in a 90 degree angle or a little bit less. And that's gonna take a lot of tension off of the tendon.
Okay.
You lose a little bit of surface area. You have more surface area with this one, like this. We lose a little bit, but it's safer on your hand. And that's all we really need for this hold.
Yeah.
We're still good here. The rest of our fingers are in. The last one that you can do is called an open hand. So the finger is down below. It's again, a more relaxed position. There's
so
one.
If you really
more,
want to pull on it though,
you really want to give
then
it.
You would have to.
Then you have to bring the thumb up over, but unnecessary for a long time.
Unnecessary. Okay. Yeah.
The last one that we can talk about with like kind of crimping is called the free finger drag, and basically that is where you're in a full open hand, and this little pinky finger usually pops off. So I'll go on the bigger hold here, and that little finger will like, pop off just because you're pulling on the tops here, and that causes the tendon to kind of curl down. And that finger goes like that. Nothing wrong with that position either. So that's how you can grip a ton of different holds, is with a full crimp, half crimp, open hand, or three finger drag. So that's how you can do a ton of them. Try and build up that half or the open hand as well. That will save your tendons a ton. So save your tendons, guys. Okay, handholds and maximizing how the best way to hold a handhold is to get the most skin contact on the hold as you can. So with a sloper, let's take a look at one that's going back here. Slopers, instead of the hold going in cut towards the wall, it's sloping away from the wall. So if you were to get a big, you know, crimp, we were losing a ton of our contact. But if we open the hand all the way up and get as much skin on there as we can, then we're in a great position. The other thing to note with slopers is that your center of gravity has a huge part to play in holding a sloper. So however you're holding it, whatever way you're pulling your force, so if I'm pulling my force on this one, kind of this way, I want my body, my center of gravity, to be underneath it. You know, the more you're gonna pull up on a sloper, the higher your center of gravity is getting towards it, and you're gonna start to lose that friction.
So you wanna be basically like, like not hanging, but like basically more extended arms on these?
Yeah.
Because on that one climb I did like yesterday or whatever, Yeah, I think I was just trying to like, I was just hanging on these a lot.
Yeah, exactly.
Like looking for my next, my hands.
Yeah, so kind of stay underneath it and stay low to it, and you'll feel it as soon as you do it. So if you hit a sloper, just kind of feel out your body and see if can I get lower on this.
It'll actually be kind of comfortable, I'm assuming.
Yeah, like, it'll be more comfortable. We found a pocket. Pocket's next up on the list. Pocket is typically a hold where you can't, it's like four or less fingers can fit inside the pocket. It's like a feature that's inward into the wall.
Yeah.
So this right here would be a pocket, and it just depends on how deep the pocket is and that kind of thing. You're either going to be like crimping it, half crimping it, or open-handing it. And then the pocket will have generally a nicer side of the feature, whether that's pulling down, pulling to the side, pulling up.
Yeah.
Something to note with this one is obviously the less fingers you can fit in there, the more strain that is going to be on, you know, one tendon versus two tendons versus three. So it's just kind of be careful with them, especially as a new climber. You might not have the finger strength in like one single digit to pull hard on a mono pocket, for example. One finger would be a mono pocket.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
I feel you.
Cool. Okay. Uh-huh. Side pulls and gastons are something, fancy French word, gaston, are two ways where the hold is, instead of it being horizontal, where we're pulling down on it all the time, now we're pulling side to side. The way to make it easier body position wise with side pulls is my left hand is pulling and I bring my body more towards the right, I'm getting more tension that way. As I bring my body towards the left, towards my left hand, I'm losing.
Yeah.
And then this will slide right up.
So if you're going to do a side pull,
it
would be like pretty normal to like have a foot somewhere over here.
Absolutely, yeah. So
I don't know.
For sure. No, this is perfect because this is a side pull right here.
Yeah.
And then this one would be a gastón.
Yeah.
But just the position of my arm, see how my elbow is up and above my head? This is a gastón. In a gastón, as I pull, I can pull my body in this way.
Yeah.
And, but just that movement like that, that would be a gastón.
Yeah.
This would be a side pull. Okay? So just the difference between having your arm like this and having it like this.
Yeah.
Let's talk about an underclean. There is one up here. It's a little high for me, but it's the only one I can really find on the wall right now. You can see that the hold, instead of it facing away where I'm pulling down, it's facing upside down, realistically. So what I want to do with this one is I actually want to pull upward with the hold.
Yeah.
So I'm taking it and I'm kind of engaging those biceps and I'm pulling and standing upward. The more and more and more and more and more you pull it in, the better it's going to be. The higher you get above it, the nicer it's going to be. It's going to be really hard to pull if it's way up here.
You can stay on one of these. That's pretty normal to stay on. Like you can pull up and stay on it.
Stay on,
Okay.
Especially someone like you has strong, nice strong biceps.
Yeah, Kian. What do those biceps look like?
There you go.
Look at those.
Make sure that you have a direct opposition with your feet. Okay, I need a counter force.
You need to be.
I need something on my foot underneath it to push down as I pull up.
Yeah.
Okay? So that is a underclean. Last one, favorite one, is called a pinch. And you can basically pinch like any hold if your hands are wide enough. But the main thing that you want to remember with pinching is that you want to get your thumb engaged as much as possible. Any hold where you can get your thumb engaged is going to make it better for you. Because this part is a perfect pinch. I'm going to engage my thumb, and what happens here is I create oppositional forces. I'm pushing down with this one, I'm pushing up with this one. Engaging that thumb allows my body movement to kind of go wherever I want it to go.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so that's why, like, on a sloper, my body, I'm kind of stuck to where I am underneath it to get that best spot for it.
Okay.
But if I can engage the thumb, like on this sloper, now I can kind of move around more. So on any hold, if you can find a spot to engage your thumb, do it. yeah, on any hold, and that oppositional force is called a pinch.
Question about footholds. Is it common to like ever use them as handholds, or like, cause I felt like sometimes like when I was climbing, like I'm like, oh shit, like I know this is a foothold, probably not supposed to use it, but like, is it common to should you never typically have to use one on a climb, like, or like?
Okay, so maybe a controversial point, but I'm gonna go ahead and say that unless you are a short climber, you probably do not need to be using any foothold as a handhold.
So basically, if I if I'm thinking of going for one, there's probably a better way to do it.
Yes. Okay. Yeah. Be somebody who's shorter or like a kid or something like that. Some of the climbs are going to be a lot too spaced out, handhold wise.
Yeah.
So that's where you might see some chalk on some of these footholds. If you are, you know, a short climber, you don't have the largest wingspan, or ape index in climbing. terminology.
Yeah.
Find another way.
Okay.
If you're finding that you need a foothold to grab, it's probably because your feet aren't actually on the right foothold.
True.
Yeah. You probably have a better foothold to get you a little bit higher up to get you that spot.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's good to know.
And that's for indoor climbing only.
Definitely indoor climbing. Yeah.
Outdoor climbing?
Outdoor climbing.
Yeah, grab what you can grab.
Yeah, for sure. Okay, sweet. So I think that wraps up the hold groups and like the ways to grip them.
Yeah.
So let's talk about now how we can put this knowledge that we now have into some practice. So let's talk about a drill that we can use. Let's go over to an easy climb. And get started on that. Okay? Cool.
Easy.
Okay, so we are at a 5.7, so we're several grade levels below what your max climb is. So I would probably go like 3, maybe 4 grades below. Depends on, you know, what you're climbing. We're gonna do an exercise called sticky hands. What the goal here is with sticky hands is to improve our accuracy when we grab holds. When you grab a hold, you do not want to keep re-gripping. That's inefficient and it's gonna cause you to tire out, you're gonna get pumped out and all that kind of stuff. Step one is we're gonna climb slow. Climbing slow is gonna allow you to focus on doing this drill. So what you wanna do, come closer, what you wanna do with this one is as you're going up, when you place your hand, it is stuck like that, okay? So that's where the sticky hand part of it comes.
Yeah.
Now we're gonna go, okay?
Okay.
So what we want to do is we want to move slow so that what you're going to do is you're going to take a look at your next hold and you're going to determine what is my next hold and how do I want to grab it.
Got
so
it.
I can't do that in like a flash.
Yeah.
So we're just going to go like, okay, like this.
Yeah.
And I'm going to really look at it, right? This has a big thumb engagement right there. This has a nice wraparound jug. So I'm going to hit that exactly as I should. And then once I place this hand on here, precisely, then I'm gonna weight it and move on to the next. That is basically it. And we're gonna do it again on an easy, nice easy route so that, again, you can focus on doing this. Cool, but remember guys, to do this on all of your warm-ups going forward, it'll become muscle memory and you'll just do it automatically, but you definitely wanna ingrain this in your day-to-day climbing. Cool, let's get you on it, let's get going.
Actually helping so much.
Yeah.
Honestly, just like, you know what, especially on these.
Yeah.
I was literally just like.
Yeah.
And then I just let my hand a lot looser, like didn't try and death grip it. Literally just let it just like, boop, just palm on it, like more.
Yeah, more surface area.
Just not as tight, like just like actually kind of not loose, but like, yeah.
Good.
And I felt that my hands were just like nowhere near as taxed. Like obviously still getting tired, but like, I was like, oh yeah, I got this climb. Like it was like,
That was so like, good. I think that's the best I've seen you climb. So that was really, that was really nice, yeah.
Oh.
Let's go. okay. All right,
it's
cool.
5.12 and probably a few days.
Yeah.
What do you think? 5.12, 5.13?
Yeah. Dream catcher, here we come.
yeah, I saw a guy climb that, yeah. What's his name? Yeah. Give me a week.
Yeah. All right, now we have more of a better foundational understanding of the different holds and how to hold them, which is really good. Always remember that usually, typically, the best way to grab something, grab a hold, is to maximize the amount of contact you have on that hold. Get that friction on there, and that's usually the best way to do it. Remember, we don't need to over-grip a bunch of stuff. If we're holding it precisely, if we're doing it accurately, that's gonna make us the most efficient climbers that we can be. So next week, we will pair sticky hands with some silent feet, and then we'll get the whole body going.
Yeah.
It'll be super good. So come back again next week, like I said before. Remember to subscribe to this channel so that you can follow the series.
Mm-hmm.
What else should I do?
Oh, like and subscribe.
Like and subscribe.
Like and subscribe.
And we'll see you guys next week.
All right.
See you.
Cool.
Okay.
Let's
cool. Go. Do you want to do the? Ciao.
Forgot about the beat.
No, that's actually a good exercise, I can't lie. Cause like, yeah.